Hello, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate, and today we're going to look at the Stealth WA2715G series. The three big options that we included on this is one, the glass, so that's the G series. Two, this one has the slide out, and three, it comes with the Arctic package. And we have several other smaller options as well. Let me break that down for you. To start off with, a few features on this side. This has the outside speakers, the LED lights up here, as well as the LED light strip across the entire portion of the awning. You'll notice that you can have the awning in and still turn this light on, whereas some of the other guys, they're putting the awning on the tube itself, which is problematic if you want to have your awning in and still have your lights on. They also have the extended gutters on the corners of the unit. They have the nicer upgraded rims right here. This has a built-in 200 watt solar panel on top of the roof, one of the largest solar panels you can buy in the industry, as well as a controller that will control how much light is getting to the batteries so that you don't overcharge your batteries. It'll also tell you how full your batteries are and things like that. In addition to that, right here on the side is a sticker, and it has a number for CoachNet. That comes with a 1 year roadside assistance that includes flat tire changes, towing, RV technical support, mobile mechanic, lockout service, fuel delivery, jump starts, service appointments, tow vehicles covered when towing. So that is all included with your first year of Forest River products brand new. Beyond the power awning, you'll notice this guy has a large storage area. Now, instead of a pass-through storage, this has a built-in prepped area for a box for a generator, and we did option this one with the generator. Two propane tanks up front here, 40 mil aluminum front, so it can handle all your weather that you're gonna throw at it. Here's your Onan generator right here. Cummins Onan 4,000 watt generator, so you can be able to use everything. Just a technical note for you, on generators like this, they have a little switch over inside here, so you can take this guy off and switch that over if you blow a breaker, basically. So if this guy's on and you don't have power inside, come switch that over. This guy right here is a spot to put your sewer hose. This guy weighs, well, its GVWR is 9980, and it can handle up to 2,500 pounds of stuff inside, so it weighs roughly about 7,500 pounds dry. With the Arctic package, that includes a few things for you. One, a fully enclosed tanks. Two, it has a radiant foil and insulation built into here, and the 12 volt heat pads on the tanks themselves. So that way you can go into a little bit colder weather and not have to worry about being the first guy to freeze up. Over here you have your hot water heater, as well as your fresh water and city water connections. This is your connection for if you decided to do cable satellite hookup right there. And then back here, this is your fuel station. So this has an onboard fuel station that not only feeds the generator, but also you can fill up your toys here too. This is a 751 key. And you have a couple keys that are tied down right in here, and they'll be here when you come and pick up the coach. And then this guy's tied down as well, but that's what you could do to fill up your toys. This ladder is a retractable ladder. This is super nice because instead of having to worry about where do you put the ladder inside and it taking up room inside your coach, or it being out permanently where it's a road hazard as you're traveling down the road, this one, as you can see, folds up so that you can access your roof, which is super nice since you have a slide out to be able to get on top of your slide out, clear whatever brush or snow or whatever got up there before you bring that slide in. This guy, you'll notice it has a nice lip to it, so as you put this guy down, you'll notice there's a lot less likelihood of water getting inside there because it has that lip, as well as the floodlights back here too. This guy can turn into a porch as well. It comes with the cables so that you can lay this guy out flat and then be able to hang out in this back deck. Now, it doesn't have the rails, but you can add railings to it if you want as an extra option. Let's go check out some features on the inside. One of the cool features I like about this particular floor plan is with the slide out option, when this guy comes in, it doesn't come in any further than what this kitchen countertop is. So that's kind of cool because then you're not blocking as you're pulling all your toys in here. So this table comes out and can store away somewhere. This one table comes out and stores away. This chair is movable. So if you wanted to take this outside or put it on your deck or whatever, you can move them around. You'll have the nicest chairs in the campsite, and they're rocker type, so pretty nice. This guy can fold into two beds as it's set right here. So you can see this couch is folded into a bed, as well as this guy right here. You get the ladder, of course, to be able to get to the top bunk. Let me show you how this guy folds up and down. So I'm gonna go ahead and fold this couch up. I'll do that right now, and then I'll show you how to put them both up. So this guy just folds like that, and then you can hang out underneath here. You can also raise this guy up and leave this guy down if you want. And then let me show you how you get your toys in here. Okay, as you can see, you have some good height here for getting your toys in and out, as well as these guys pull across if you want some privacy back here while you're sleeping. You can pull these across and make it more into like a bedroom area. Over here, you'll notice that these ramps are, you can actually go over the wheel well. They make it into a ramp so that you can drive on top of it. So if you needed that little bit of extra space, you can work with it. Here you'll notice that you have all your TV connections. So you have your video in and audio in, as well as a 12 volt outlet if you decided to add a TV right here. This is where you start your generator. This is where you control your awning, the bed control switch here, your slide out switch, as well as a charging center. So you have 12 volt outlet as well as two USB outlets to be able to charge your phone and whatever else. And then this is the fuel gauge to tell you how much fuel you have, as well as a black, fresh, and gray tank. With the G-Series package, you also get the kicker audio system. So it's a little bit nicer stereo system, as well as it's a touch screen, so you can adjust things that way. And then that includes the larger bass underneath here, or subwoofer underneath here as well. Another option we did is the stainless steel appliance package, and we upgraded the refrigerator to an 8-cubic foot refrigerator as opposed to the standard 6-cubic foot refrigerator. So as you can see, this is pretty large. These are your cables, by the way, for that door that goes down in the back to make a patio. And this is the remote for your stereo system. In here, I'll point out a couple other cool things that are in here just to know about. Inside your package, you'll get a couple things. One is a little guy here, so this makes it so that you don't have interference if you plug in a TV. And then it also has some little clips in here, these little blue clips. Those are to hold your refrigerator out about an inch, so that when you are putting this guy away for storage, it doesn't let your fridge close all the way, so you don't get that moldy fridge after a while. You'll notice this is nice solid surface Corian countertops, large one basin sink with a pull down sink faucet that's higher, so that you can put your bigger dishes and stuff like that in here. Sometimes they split that so that you can't get all your dishes in here. You'll notice this is also all flush, so both your stovetop and your counters, sink counters work as cutting boards and just a lot of extra counter space to work with, as well as this guy folds up and doubles as a backsplash as well. Little oven in here, microwave, cabinetry up here on top. The other cool thing I like that Stealth does is all of their cabinetry has a lip to it. So they have this nice crown molding across the top, and they have a probably about a 2-inch lip up here. So if you wanted to throw whatever, like sandwich bread or chips or something like that, it's not gonna come flying off here too easily with that 2-inch lip. This guy has the next level floor. This is water resistant, cold crack resistant, quick clean water layer, resists scuffs and scrapes, resistant to mold and mildew, made in the USA. As we go back here, these are your spots for your heat pad switches. So you can turn those guys on. They are regulated on 12 volts, so you can run them off your battery, although they would draw down your battery pretty quick. So I'd recommend turning on your generator or being plugged in if you're gonna turn those on, but those will protect your tanks down to negative 11 degrees. Inside the bathroom, you'll notice you have some cupboards to work with, as well as a nice medicine cabinet, more storage down low, a nice neo-angled shower, plenty of ceiling height here, as well as a skylight, which is kind of nice. They continue doing the LED lights through the bathroom here. Plenty of room around the commode. And then this is the Jack and Jill style bathroom. So you'll notice that it has two entries, one from the main hallway and one from the bedroom area. Now over here, this is your controller panel. So you can mess with this guy and this will control how much sunlight you're getting or to your batteries. Light switch for your bedroom area right here, as well as some TV hookups if you decide to add a TV right here. This is also has a backer panel into it, so if you wanted to put a TV, it'll hold the weight of it. Walk around bed, which people love, instead of the bed being pushed into one corner. Lots of storage on both sides here. And then these guys do pull out, and they're on nice metal glides so that they slide really nice. This guy does have a 12 or a 110 outlet over there, as well as a 110 outlet over here. And this also has a charging port over here. So USB and 12 volt ports over on this side as well. And then LED light up here, as well as some more counter space here. This guy does lift up. So if you wanted to add more storage in here, you can. Now, this is all open, so even if you wanted to cut a hole in that eventually, you could access the outside storage area if you wanted to. One more quick feature before we go, this is pretty cool. This is a keyless entry, so if you go to your storage lot and all of a sudden you forgot your keys, no worries. You can use your keyless entry to get into your camper, as well as if you're going on a hike and you don't want to carry the keys in your pocket as you're hiking around or four-wheeling and don't want to lose it who knows where on the trail. You can just lock this manually or with the keyless entry and not have to worry about that. Great coach. This is definitely one of Stealth's number one selling floor plans, and they are the number one selling toy hauler on the West Coast and west of the west half of the United States, basically. Stealth is the best one, and you can see why for sure. If you have any questions, call me up. My name's Mate. You can reach us at thegreatoutdoorsrv.com or call us up at 970-313-4337 or come visit us here at The Great Outdoors at 3511 West Service Road in Evans, Colorado. And we have a full parts and service department. We can line up financing for you. We do take trades. Let us know what we can do to help you out. Thanks.